Good afternoon, and welcome to First Fridays at 5 at Grace Lutheran Church in downtown Milwaukee. I'm Kevin Becker, the Minister of Music at Grace Church, and thank you for joining us. Today we are pleased to present classical guitarist and composer Brad Conroy in a virtual concert. A link to the concert program can be found in the video description. There you'll find today's repertoire, as well as information about our guest artist and upcoming concerts. The first Friday in the month of April this year is Good Friday. We will not present a concert that day. Instead, you're welcome to join us for worship at 12:10, 5 o'clock, or 6:30 p.m. Information about all of that can be found on our website, gracedowntown.org. Thanks again for joining us, and enjoy the concert. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank Grace Lutheran Church for having me. It was quite an adventure for me to come from Chicago to Milwaukee today. It's the first adventure I've had in a year. So I would like to thank Kevin and Rachel and all of Grace Lutheran Church for making this possible. And my one awesome audience member, this is outstanding. I hope, sincerely hope, that in the coming months we can have many more of these concerts with people in the audience. The next piece on my program is Granada by Isaac Albeniz. And this piece is originally written for piano, and like much of the repertoire we play in classical guitar, we've transcribed it for the classical guitar. And the story is that Albeniz would take a little train ride around Spain, and every city he came to, he'd write a little tone poem for it. And this one is Granada, after the famous Andalusian city. Thank you. Preludes for the classical guitar. You can stream them on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Music, CD Baby, wherever. And thank you again to Grace Lutheran Church. This hall is awesome. The acoustics are just outstanding. So thank you again. Four Preludes. Thank you. The next group of pieces is a little set by my most favorite composer, Fernando Sor. As my first classical guitar teacher told me, Sor, when you play Sor on the guitar, it's the closest you will get to playing Mozart. And so these are, I think, five studies by the classical era Fernando Sor composer. And I will be altering the second two on the set. I will do the exercise in sixths, followed by the Opus 35, number 22.
Thank you.
you, thank you. The next set of pieces are two movements from Manuel Maria Ponce's Sonata Mexicana. For those who don't know classical music all that well, a sonata after the Baroque era, sonata would indicate a piece that is 4 to 5 movements long, meaning that there are like 4 individual pieces that make up one giant work. And this sonata by Ponce, I believe, is the first sonata written for the guitar in the 20th century, and it was written for our most famous guitarist, Andrés Segovia. And Ponce wrote this piece as a, like, extending a gesture of friendship to Segovia. And in the second movement, which is that I'm playing tonight, but which is the third movement in the sonata, was originally titled De Mexico, and it uses some themes from the, I suppose, the hat dance song that you may have heard. And so these are two movements from Manuel Maria Ponce's Sonata Mexicana, originally or written for Andrés Segovia. Thank you.
Thank you.
I believe on the program are four pieces by Cuban composer Leo Brower.
Thank you.
next three pieces are standards in the classical guitar repertoire. Three pieces by Francisco Tárrega, a Spanish romantic composer, and the last of the three, Recuerdos de la Alhambra, Remembering the Alhambra, like a Moorish castle in Granada, Spain. And it's written in a style called tremolo, which almost sounds like a few instruments. You have like this repeated note in the top with a bass line over it. And as a young boy in the 90s who started playing like Metallica and Led Zeppelin, I heard Andre Segovia play this piece, and I just could not believe my ears. And from that day forward, I decided to dedicate myself to the classical guitar. So, three pieces by Francisco Tárrega. Thank you. Thank you. The Tarantelle by Johann Caspar Merz will conclude tonight's concert. This is a great representation of late 19th century Romantic era music, very similar to Chopin or Liszt on the piano. So this is the Tarantelle by Johann Caspar Merz. And I want to thank everyone again for coming tonight, for watching it online. Kevin, Rachel, thank you so much for making this happen, and everyone at Grace Lutheran Church, what an awesome venue. I really hope to be back. Please find me on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, wherever you guys hang out, and thank you so much. And the Tarantelle by Johann Caspar Merz will conclude tonight's concert. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you again.